Hi guys, hello, hey Cheryl, Wada, hey Sherry, I know, hey Alan, thank you Sherry, and Wada, share, please. Swipe and invite. I'm giving myself hearts now. Hey Marguerite. Oh, thank you, lovely bald girl. Share, please. Thank you. Thanks, Rushy. Thank you very much, Monica. Mr. Sod. You can DM me, Katha. Time for you to walk out, walk in your own shoes. I'm chucking that. You choose what's on your mind. Hey, Karen. Share, please. The music, the song is very apt. Thanks, Julie. Turn the radio on, play your favorite song. Hey, Godzilla. First day on Scope, eh? Okay, kids. Hi, guys. Listen, I've got to tell you, it's been a bit of a mad 24 hours. Thanks for the hearts. I tell you what, it's been a bit crazy, cray cray. I didn't expect quite such a reaction. It's been mind-blowing. It's been mind-blowing. The video from yesterday that I took, one of the videos, because obviously I've taken a few of them, has gone slightly viral, I suppose, is the phrase we use. And I just want to thank everybody for reaching out to me and, you know, doing communications. I've just been totally overwhelmed by the response, and I mean, to know that Paul Joseph Watson retweets one of my videos, it's quite surreal. And Oh, thanks, Monica. I mean, I did another video yesterday, but I've had to hide it because I gave out some personal information. So, but there's going to be more footage to come. I've got plenty of footage if people want to see more. I've just got to try and put it together. But yeah, it's been amazing. I think things came together. Bridget, I met at the park yesterday. Happened to be listening to me having a quite I don't want to say heated conversation, but I was talking to a few people and Bridget was listening and, as it happened, had the park regulations on her phone, and a group were going to write a letter, a petition to I think to the chief inspector or to somebody to question why the rules apply to one section of the population, and well, multiple sections of the population and not to another. So I just decided yesterday was a good day after I had a coffee and a warm up to, as it happens, raise the issue. I did mention something at Tommy Robson's on the Robinson's on the speech day about it, but was pretty much dismissed, and I didn't have the information to hand. But yesterday, just happenstance came about, and there you go. I was ready. I wasn't quite expecting the reaction that I got from being surrounded and heckled and harassed and all the rest of it, where it was quite well, you saw what happened. Yes, I say it just so happened that Bridget had that information on her phone, and she offered to buy me a coffee because I was having, well, I'd been talking for a couple of hours with some other people, having discussions. I like to call them discussions, even though they're not really discussions. And when I finished with one particular group of people, Bridget just said, I met her and she said, oh, just wanted to, you know, we could buy you a coffee. And she and her wonderful son, we went and had coffee and a chat, and that's when I found out that she had the actual regulations about the park and what can and cannot be done. And so we went back after we had a coffee, and well, the rest is a little bit of is history, as they say. Anywho, I cannot believe, my mind is blown by the response. I just want to thank everybody for being amazing and sending me so many wonderful messages of support. And I really hope that something will positive will come from this attitude change from certain people in power. Well, we shall see. But you know, I've stayed quiet long enough, and Tommy Robinson is a very inspirational person, as is Katie Hopkins, as are other people who've been silenced or they've attempted to silence. So I thought I'd put my 2 cents worth in, speak up, and yeah, amazing. So I just ask for everybody's prayers, because obviously I've kind of upset a few people. And but onwards and upwards, and I'm looking forward to the 6th of May, because guess who's gonna be there? Yeah, wild horses wouldn't keep me away. So the battle goes on for free speech. We need to the time is now, it's time to speak out. Yeah, good question. What is hate speech? That's and what's Islamophobia? You know, it's all a stunt, politically speaking, to silence the normal, regular people who object to what's going on to their countries. So, well, it's not just this country, it's the whole of Europe, and America's changing. You know, America's changed horribly in the last, especially the last 8 years, but especially since the so-called Arab Spring, which wasn't really a spring at all. It was really the winter, or autumn into a winter. So, I'm hoping that, you know, the amazing thing is, all I can say is the reaction has been amazing, and I think if people, I don't know, I'm gobsmacked by what's happened. I'm absolutely hoping that something positive will come out of it. America's changed a huge, great deal, but I'm hopefully the God Emperor Donald Trump, he's changing it. He's getting it back. He's going to change it back to the great, great country it once was. Before, well, I'd say since the Clintons got their hands on the White House. Anywho, hey Joey, how are you? I've had a bit of a mad day, mad 24 hours. It's been pretty incredible. Never had my Twitter go bonkers. Well, oh, excellent. Wait a minute, persecuted. Well, yeah, that's not. Oh, you just reminded me. I've got to go somewhere tomorrow. Speaking about persecution, I have. Oh, thanks a lot. You just totally reminded me. I've got to go somewhere tomorrow. If you want to check out my YouTube channel, what's it, Amy_CrazyWorld, and see my discussion with the police, if you haven't seen it, and this is about a different matter altogether, it's to do with officially called hate speech. Yeah, pray for me for tomorrow, because, well, I don't know, I might be finding myself behind bars, you know what I mean? I know I'm being very vague, but I don't really want to go into too much detail. Just check out my video. Let's see, I'll show you it. Actually, no, you know what? I'll show you my video. Should I show you my video now? I'll show you where to find it. Hang on. Let me see if I can find my video, and I'll show you what you need to look for. Oh, no, I can't. Wait a minute. Let me show you what video. Miss Amy's Crazy World. We're living in a crazy world, guys. I did pick an appropriate name for my Twitter handle. So it's called. Okay, so my YouTube, little YouTube channel, which is it's a very little channel because I haven't been able to quite get the things up on it properly. I'm having technical difficulties, but I have uploaded this one saying. And this is completely a different topic altogether, but the title is UK Police Work in 2018, God Help Us All. And what I'm going to say to you is that it was about a month ago. Oh, I've actually had 41,000 views. It's only a 6-minute video, and I've had 41,000 views. It's from a month ago. And I know, it's so crazy. And it's my encounter with the British police about, I had a little disagreement in a car park, verbally, very minor disagreement, which has been, well, there's been a bit of a fiction created over what was said. So if you'd like to, how many likes? Let me see, hang on, if I play it, I'll find out, I suppose. If you guys want to play it, let me see. Oh, what do you mean the video's unavailable? Hang on a second. No, it's not. That's not true. Here it is. I've had. Oh, wow. Well, I've had 635 likes and 66 dislikes. And quite frankly, it's hard to know what the dislikes are about. But if you guys want to check this video out, you'll see what I'm going to be doing tomorrow. Oh, thank you. Oh, my God. I keep forgetting you can hear me singing. Well, thanks. That's very kind of you. Yeah, so I've had 41,500 views. I mean, that is just mind-blowing. Mind you, my yesterday's video, I've had 15,000 views on my Periscope from yesterday's police video. You don't have to hate, but don't want to like murderers and rape. Exactly. Yeah, they probably are from NNN. Yeah, Manganese Network. Anyway, kids, that might be... There's only 6 minutes long. They opened my living room window, by the way, to get my attention, the police, on a Sunday afternoon, about 3 weeks ago. Unannounced, opened my living room window to ask me to open my door. So, I know, MNN, nightmare. MNN who? MNN what? Yeah, they opened my living room window from the street, without warning, scared the bejesus out of me. Well, I know. I've got quite the story, children. I could tell my own little stories about my encounters. Yeah, I agree, actually. I will agree with you. I do have every intention of relocating back to America. Yes. No, I agree with you. MNNR. Yep. Agreed. So, kids, this was just a quick catch-up because I can't believe I'm saying this, but I've got a lot of tweets I've got to reply to. And I want to say thank you to Anne Vandersteel for a lovely message she gave me. Yeah. I just can't believe the people communicating with me. It's quite astonishing. And I had somebody, an MBE, somebody with an MBE remarked on my yesterday's encounter. So, guys, you know, I don't know what to say. I just felt the need to speak out yesterday. Well, I've done it for a few times now. I know I've spoken out a few times, but I just seem to have touched on something, an emotion that I'm hoping will make a difference. For the better, of course. Oh, yes, my moral compass. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's just, it's all quite surreal at the moment, guys. Yeah, poor Joseph Watson. That's amazing. I wish I could show you the tweet, but my Twitter thing isn't working on my computer. It's on my phone. But just look at my Twitter handle. I know, poor Joseph Watson. My goodness me. What a thrill. He retweeted. Well, thank you. Oh my God, don't. That's amazing. Do you think I'm brave? Huh? Well, yeah, it's strange to be called brave. I just wanted to speak out. I've had enough. I got fed up with it. I'm fed up with what I'm seeing, so I decided to... Oh, thank you. Well... I don't know, when you've got right, when you've got truth, when you've got... I don't know. I know, I have to be safe. Yeah, I do have a few videos on my Periscope that people can catch up with if you like. Feel free, I've got loads of videos on Periscope, but there's a few that are hidden because... Oh, thanks, Cheryl. Wow. I've got a few videos that are hidden on my Periscope because some people might get a little bit upset. Have you guys seen the Bacon Lady one? That's kind of funny. Did you see my one with Ali Dawa? Anybody? I don't know what's happened. That's weird. Oh, that's right. This is my... Oh. Do you guys see this one? This one.
God,
oh, hang on.
Guys.
Did you see that one?
I'm on the wrong side of the blooming line. I'm on the wrong side. Swiping and bite. It's all kicking off. I'm on the wrong side. I'm on the wrong side of the line. I don't know where my minder is. I've got nowhere to find where he is. But it's all going to kick.
This is from my angle. Oh, that's really loud. That's so nice. Thanks. That's a lovely thing to say, Kath.
Again.
Somebody from Head Education Crew has uploaded a few of my videos. Yeah, this is the one with the alley.
Where? I can't even see anything.
What happened was, this was, thanks, Sherry. This was on Tommy Robinson's speech day, and I was on the wrong side of the, I was in, I don't know, I've got to be careful with what I say, obviously, but I was not on the friendly side, let's put it that way. And, so if you want to go on to, I keep on losing my train of thought. Yes, my verbals with the police. Yes, I did get a bit lost, Mr. Sod. Yeah, this was, I gave her father a hard time for having his daughter there. I was trying to find Joey. I was trying to find Joey Benedetto.
There.
I know, Cheryl. Yeah. That's right. They were. But he quickly gave up on that.
Look for police van. I can't see anything. Right, listen, I'm right in the thick of it. Right here, guys. Let me see if I can find Uh-oh, Muhammad's here. I'm surrounded, by the way. I'm surrounded. All right, I don't know where the van is. He's waiting for me? All right, I've got to try and find a van. I don't know where it is. Is it near the... All right, show me.
That's right, actually.
Right, I'm going to move from where I am. Oh my God, this is not a place.
You're
for
right,
a child,
Gareth.
By the way. This is the worst place for a child. There's trouble. There's already been trouble. It's going to be violent.
Well, I'll get out and see if the kid's up. No, why?
It's already started.
Well, not here.
Hey?
Not here, has it?
You're an idiot. Well, sorry, be here if she could understand what the hell's going on. You're the father. You have a responsibility for her. You should not be here with all the trouble.
And you don't, so...
That's okay, missy.
You should not have her there. You're an idiot. Excuse me?
I'd kindly ask you to respect that.
No, I don't respect you. She can't speak for herself. She's a baby. She does not belong where there's trouble.
My child.
Yeah, and you're doing a shitty job. Shame on you. This is no place for a child. You mind your business. She doesn't understand. You think she understands, you idiot.
You're swearing at him in front of
you. Are you an idiot?
Exactly.
My own ideology. Myself. Free speech. That's what I represent.
Yeah, but what are you doing, Casey?
Excuse me?
I want to know who you're contending with.
Me.
Enemies.
Amy. Amy. A British citizen. I have no enemies. I want free speech.
Okay.
And I'm here for free speech.
Okay.
I have no enemies.
I just wanted to know who you're contending with.
Excuse me?
I'm trying to bomb the free speech.
That's what I'm doing. I'm here for free speech. All right, Sunshine, what are you here for? No, you don't like free speech?
No.
You don't like free speech?
I never said that.
Well, what you do...
I'll move it forward a bit. I gave him a hard time.
Drink beer, so, you know, I'm not really here for the beer. I'm here for a bloody cup of coffee.
Wait, here we go.
Talk to him, bloody hell. Excuse me.
This is from my angle.
Excuse me. Excuse me. Excuse me. Hey. Excuse me. Excuse me. Talk to me. Don't shout. This is free speech here. This is England. And this is free speech right here. This is free speech. This is free speech. Christian. You.
I tell you, this guy right here was a right royal pain in the neck. He was like a bloomin' pillar. He wouldn't get out of the way. He wouldn't get out of the way. I didn't know he was guarding the guy that I was, you know, trying to get past. I wanted to get to Ali Dawa. I know.
Tommy Robinson is a hero. Tommy Robinson is a hero. Right, speak to me. Speak to me, Mr. Big Man. Speak to me, Mr. Big Man. Yeah, you can't face a woman. Why can't you talk to me, you chicken shit?
Oh, pardon the language.
I'll talk to you. No.
Yeah.
Excuse me, could you get out of my way? I want to talk to this idiot here. Get out of my way. Well, look, I'm a woman. I've got a bacon sandwich on me, so watch out. Look, let me talk to you idiots. Who the hell do you think you are? What do you think you're doing to my country? What are you doing to my country? No, it's not. No, it's not your country. You're trying to take my country away from me, you son of a bitch. Get out of my way, you squirt. Hey. Yeah. Yeah, you're taking my freedom of speech away. Your bloody Sharia law. Your stupid blasphemy law. You're taking my freedom of speech away. Get out of my way! Right, I'm here. Why you got your face covered up? What? You scared? You scared? You're obviously scared. You scared? Yeah, I'll talk to you.
Amy.
Yeah, hello, Ali.
I'm not here to take over your country.
Right?
I'm here to live in harmony and peace.
So what's all the trouble then? Why did a guy hit a policeman with a stick, a Muslim?
How do you know it was a Muslim?
I saw it.
Can I ask you something? Listen, brother, listen.
No, wait, I'm talking to him.
How come your people go around the world?
They're not my people.
Your people?
They're not my, I'm a person. I'm an individual. I'm an individual woman, and I speak.
Yeah. I'm not here to take over your country.
Right, so?
I'm here. We come here every Sunday for the past 4 or 5 years.
Yeah.
I talk about religion with different kinds of people. They came here today.
Listen, I'm not an idiot. I've got a Quran. Don't try and double talk me.
Okay.
I know exactly what you stand for.
Can you tell me why and the Quran tells me not to live in harmony with you?
Sorry?
Can you tell me
all through the bloody Quran. It says kill the kuffar.
Listen, Ali, I'm not a fucking
kuffar. It says to kill the kuffar wherever you find them.
Why is your people killing everyone around the world?
You're killing everybody.
Your people are.
You're blowing people up. You're blowing people up. You're stabbing people. You're raping people. You're invading. You are. No, we don't do that. We're civilized.
You're civilized.
Okay? Yeah, we are. Are you threatening me now, Mr. Religion of Peace? No, this is a free speech.
You're an old woman. Can you please go away?
Piss off.
Can I ask you?
Don't touch me. No, I've got bacon, guys. I've got some bacon.
Oh, I don't know why it stopped. It got stopped.
I mean, when you say you stopped, I'm a British, a Muslim, Islam, Islamic, not every Muslim.
Nice, Tommy!
Only Islamic.
Tommy!
Jihadis. Well, I can say what you're for Palestine.
Amy,
so I don't really.
So?
Well, that's what that scarf represents. Yes.
You made it clean.
Sorry?
You made it clean. In my Quran, it teaches me not to live
yes.
in harmony.
532,
424.
Surah 532. Surah 532.
Yeah. Is not talking about.
Tell me what it says. Quote it. Go on.
It says, for example, it's talking about those who broke the treaty with the Prophet Muhammad and didn't want to live in harmony. It talks about highway robbers. Yes?
And what does it say?
The Muslims.
What does it say?
No.
Listen, stop interrupting. It's very rude. We're having a conversation.
Your people created.
It's not my people, perhaps. No, you did. Muhammad did, actually. Muhammad was the first one. Muhammad was the first one. So listen, I'm having a conversation. I'm having a civilized conversation. Yeah, come on. Talk to me. Tell me about 532. Talk to me about 532.
Do you have any idea why 532 is revealed?
Yeah, because it sucks.
Okay, it was revealed because it sucks.
Listen, you guys are practicing the Sharia law in this country.
No, we don't.
Yes, you do.
No, we don't.
Now, that's lying.
No, don't.
Don't do taqiyya on me.
Taqiyya's not in the
You are lying.
I'm not Shia.
Tell the truth. It doesn't matter. Sunni, Shia, the Quran is your book, right?
You came here with a bacon in your hand.
Yeah, I did.
It seems like you've watched a lot of Tommy Robinson's videos.
Well, No. I am Amy. Nothing to do with Tommy.
Amy.
Don't do all this gathering and grouping.
Yeah, okay.
Okay? Yeah.
You claim that in my book it tells me
to kill the kuffar.
Okay, can you kindly show me where in the Quran that he orders me?
Can you not read it then?
Can you please quote me?
Can you? I don't need to. That you're practicing it.
How? Can you?
You're practicing it.
Am I killing you now?
Aloha snagbar, you guys shout that.
Could be answering one question.
You?
Am I killing you now?
Well, you better not be, otherwise you'll be arrested. You're being an idiot now. You're not having a conversation. So you're telling me that Muhammad didn't tell people to spread Sharia, Islam, there'll be peace when Sharia is around the world. Well, you better not be here to kill me, you idiot. Jesus.
If Muslims were so bad, would she be here right now?
No, I happen to be brave. I'm not scared of you lot. I'm not scared of you lot.
Come on.
Why are you wearing a mask?
Huh?
Why are you covering your face?
I have to.
Why?
Look,
why? I thought Islam was a religion of peace. What's all the tough guys? Well, you shouldn't have to if you're all about peace.
Oh, stop it. You see, we actually are stopping.
Listen,
I
saw...
Get the camera, please. I need to say something.
You want to talk? Yeah, go
ahead. Why does your people...
Don't say my
go
people.
The world,
we're individual.
Country,
no, shut up. That's a load of rubbish.
Resources.
Why does Islam... You crap in the streets! You crap in the streets! You're so disgusting! You're vile, I know everything!
Your people are vile! Have a bath!
No, you need one, I thought I could smell something.
Excuse me, can I ask one question?
What? Yes.
If one of the Muslim women were to be down there...
Yeah, she'd be fine. She'd be absolutely as safe as can be... What?
Look at what's happening here. Look,
well, right now, I could be attacked at any second.
No, you wouldn't. I promise you.
How do you know?
I wouldn't allow a single person to attack.
Well, and a Muslim woman, she wouldn't get hurt over there.
Look at what's happening right now.
We're
pushing the Muslims back.
Yeah. You guys are just liars.
This is what I'm trying
you
to
know
say.
The truth. I know the truth.
You cannot speak.
I've seen it with my own eyes. I hear it with my own ears. I hear about killing the kuffar, the bombings, the slaughterings, the rapings, the killings.
I am not raping.
They're running people over with cars.
That's the end of that. Well, for some reason my footage stopped there.
Warlord.
Oh, I will,
my
Sophie.
You lot are trying to take over.
Oh.
And we're not going to let it happen.
By the way.
Excuse me?
It actually continues.
You're in Europe, for Christ's sake.
Look what you're doing in the Middle East.
We're not there, Sonny Jim. You're blowing your own people up.
You guys
are so ignorant. The Quran is a book of hate. I've read the Quran. No, it's in plain English.
Don't talk about Islam.
He told to kill everybody, take over,
read Arabic.
I don't need to read Arabic.
Does he do? The Quran
is it's all the same. People have translated it into English.
Arabic is one of the most complex languages. What book are your people reading to go around destabilizing
my people?
So why are you coming to say my people?
Warriors are you, bloody jihadi, trying to take over. Sons of bitches. Bloody English people, you're an idiot. You're a fucking idiot.
I'm sorry about the language.
You don't like freedom of speech. Do you know what blasphemy law is?
Don't touch me. Do not touch me.
Do you know what blasphemy law is? Do you agree with it?
No.
So what are you doing then?
Well, I'm just saying you can't
believe
all
in
these people the same way.
All the ones here, trust me. All the ones here don't want free speech. They want Sharia law. If you think that that's not... What?
You can't speak for them.
If that's what you are seriously deluded. You don't think these people here want to shut free speech up. Why are they here? Tommy Robinson just wanted to do a speech. What are all this lot doing here to stop him?
Are they stopping him?
Yes, they are.
Dialogue, madam.
What?
Dialogue, madam. Dialogue.
Oh, no, you guys like to run over and ask questions later.
No, madam.
You like to kill and then ask.
No, madam.
It's too late.
Listen,
I'm not an idiot. I'm not an ignorant. I'm not a stupid English twit who's letting you guys take over. I hate you guys. I absolutely hate Islam. It is everything that I hate. It's against a woman, 100%.
That's fine. Do you know what generally for me, I find the saddest thing? It's the fact that the propaganda has become so severe that you feel that you're justified in coming to justify a whole brand of people.
What's going on here?
Honestly,
listen, Sammy Jim.
Honestly,
listen.
Honestly.
I know what I'm talking about. You can't talk Takiya to me. Just don't be stupid, okay? You guys are vile. Islam is vile. It's a hateful ideology that wants to spread death and destruction, rape and pillaging. I know I've got a Quran, and I understand it. And I can see it being practiced all over the world, all over Europe, okay? What?
I'm a human being.
Sorry?
I'm a human being.
Yeah?
You're a human being.
Right.
So where is the harm in having this stuff?
If you're wearing that, okay, that's a symbol.
The thing is,
that's a symbol. And it's against democracy.
I'm not happy with
Hey, Christy.
There you are. You love it.
Because honestly,
you love it.
Honestly,
you love it.
You can see my face. Generally, I'm emotional.
Sorry?
All of this is not helping anyone.
So what are you doing to stop this then?
Their message is that we want to bring communities together and we want to talk
what
about
a load of rubbish.
Hey,
you're delusional. Sorry, hello. Look at me. Look at me in the eye.
No, Christy. This was actually the Tommy Robinson day. I call it Tommy Robinson. It was, you know, a couple of weeks ago. Was it a couple of weeks? God, it seems like not that long ago. 2 weeks? 2 weekends ago? Well, it's not this weekend, not the one before. So it's 3 weekends ago, I suppose. So this was when it was cold.
When you're talking to me, you're talking a load of twaddle. You are talking a load of rubbish. You are talking a load of rubbish.
Yeah, that's right. Anyway, this is a very long video. I mean, it's actually, do you know, this is 3 hours long. I can't believe it's 3 hours long. What the heck was I doing for 3 hours? I was just going around.
Looking for Joey.
Oh, yeah, I was looking for Joey. Looking for Joey, lovely Joey, and then this guy, I had fun with him.
No, they're people.
Okay, so
there are people.
The Kurds are not Muslims.
I don't know. I'm not familiar with Kurds. Okay, so they're Muslims.
Okay,
so he killed.
Okay, so
Muslims.
We were protecting the Kurds.
Who?
England, when they went.
I don't know who you represent. Who do you represent? No. Do you think of yourself as a Muslim?
Oh my God.
British. Citizen first. So Muslim comes first. Right, that's what I'm saying. So you believe you're loyal to Islam first and then Britain. You see, that doesn't fit here. In England, you are British first and the religion comes second. Religion comes second. Because that's how it's always been here. We separated church from state.
Oh, so you mean even in regards to Christianity as well? So
yeah.
British before you're Christian.
Yeah.
They are. I thought I only applied if you're Muslim and go against them. But okay, fair enough.
I tell you what, I was a little tear away that day, just going around going rah, 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 rah. douche, and the next one, douche, bada boosh.
I know, you went to the wrong place, you got the wrong bus.
And it started blooming snowing.
Well, this guy's getting worried about being filmed. We've got a little jihadis right here.
It was snowing, it was cold.
Education, guys. Anybody who's got a moustache, I mean a beard, and no moustache, is a jihadi. All right? It's snowing now.
Anyway, if you guys...
I know I do. I know more about Islam than Muslims.
No, I don't. I didn't mean that.
Educating the Muslims.
I didn't mean that.
532, Takiya.
I don't actually know more. That was just
when I'm right. Ooh.
That was an exaggeration.
Watch out, these guys might go for me. But I have got my spray here, by the way. Right, does anybody know where... I need a drink.
Accountant?
Okay, good.
Now, he was the one who hit the policeman. He was the one who hit the policeman. And he was wandering around within 2 hours of the time that he... oh, thanks, Monica. I'm 99% sure that this was the policeman. I mean, this was the one who hit the policeman. And all he did was change his jacket.
Great. Excellent.
How on earth are you telling me you're living on my money, tax money? I'm guaranteed.
I didn't say anything about
you. Do.
I didn't.
I can guarantee
excuse
you.
Me. I have
how
not.
You are swearing me.
Excuse me.
And my
how
belief,
you come
religion.
To this country? To
what?
Why are you swearing me? My religion. What you don't know?
I know it. I've seen you practicing it. Sharia law. You're killing. You're slaughtering. 532. Give me 532. 532.
I'm giving the Quran.
532.
Yes.
Give me 532.
Yeah, give me 532.
532.
What the context?
Exactly what it says. What it says. Read it. You don't know what you're talking about, so shut up. You just said, na, 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 na. England. You're not, so go away. Ba, 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 ba. Yeah, 532. Shut up. I'm not talking to you. I'm not talking. Oh, what are you talking about? Don't talk to me. Bloody annoying. You're rude. You're rude. You're shouting at me. I am not. I'm not talking to you. You don't know the truth. You don't know the truth.
Tell me the truth. Tell me the truth about your country.
It's a democratic country. I don't know he did it. That's lies. That's a lie. That's a lie. I don't care. I don't care. I don't care. I don't give a shit.
Whoops.
Shut up.
She was like, I don't know where she's from, Eastern Europe, and she was just standing, just yelling at me. I was trying to, you know, have a, get this bloke to read out the 532, and she was just there, ma, 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 yelling, oh, where are you doing, blah, 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 and she's a Muslim, so, yeah.
The truth is, Islam is evil.
I'm Polish and I'm Muslim
evil.
And I'm proud
and you're
to
evil.
Be.
Oh, that's right, sorry, she's Polish and she was Muslim and she was proud to be, apparently, so.
Idiot.
You are.
You're
an idiot.
And you're controlled by your men. You're evil. You're worse than a man. You're worse than a man. You're worse than a man.
True is painful, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Go away.
You can't
control yourself.
I will
gather on her, blah, 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 blah. Now you do some fight against all. The city we captured, the house ransacked. The women raped, yeah. Half the city we go to exile, the rest of the people not be taken for tea. New living English right fire. That's not 532.
What did you read it?
That is not 532.
What did you read it here?
This is not 532.
It's
not 532. It's not my Bible.
It's your Bible.
I'm not reading the Bible, you idiot.
You are.
The Quran is a problem.
What is the Quran is a problem?
Oye, no me digas eso.
Destruction around the world.
Where?
Islam wants to.
¿Quién es una bruja?
I don't care the numbers.
Wait, Noala.
I don't care the numbers. I don't care about the numbers.
You are
there's enough people causing a lot of trouble.
Excuse me? You're living on my tax money.
I'm not living on your bloody tax money, you idiot.
You are.
How dare you?
How dare you? I'm doing the facts.
Hey, Dennis.
You're an idiot.
I'm an idiot.
You don't know any facts. You just wrote. I asked you to give me 5.
Pero qué pasa, Noala?
I'm giving the Bible because.
532.
Oh, ella es una bruja, sí.
532.
What's your religion then?
She's atheist.
I'm British, so there.
Oh, she's a British. And we are dumb.
You like being controlled by men, that's your problem. We British women do not get controlled by men. We have our rights. You're not like. Listen.
You will not talk to this rubbish today.
So if you were in.
Oh,
you're going to just shout. Do you want to let me talk? Let me talk. Are you going to let me talk? Are you going to let me talk?
I'm telling you.
Are you going to let me talk? Are you going to let me talk?
Okay.
So if you. Wait, I can only do one. I don't care.
Who put for you?
My grandfather.
Moyen.
My grandfather was in the war. Okay, sorry? My grandfather. If you're an Islamic country, you are not allowed to leave the house alone. Is that okay with you?
Why are you telling me this?
That's true.
Why? Why are you to this?
Because I see it.
What do you mean you've seen it?
Women. Oh, so now you're going to deny the truth. Now you're denying the truth.
What do you mean you've seen it?
You're not allowed to leave the house.
532.
Yeah.
Start from 29.
And do 4:30 to 4
I'm giving you from the context.
Give me 5:32.
I'm giving the context.
Why is the Quran from 29? Is not one verse, is it all?
You quote, they quote that, okay?
No,
they quote.
Look, I'm giving you from the 29.
They quote.
We need
sister.
To study.
You're so rude.
You want something what we don't
how
know what
you
mean.
Why are you
don't shush me.
Don't shush me.
Don't shush me.
Don't shush us.
I can talk wherever I want.
Don't shush us.
There's no point in shouting. There's no point in shouting.
You're shouting.
You're shouting. I'm talking quiet. Give me 532.
Yeah, I'm giving you.
Read it.
I have started from 29.
532 I want.
529.
Just give me 532. See? They can't do it. 532. No, that's not what you said.
If someone break the treaty, they have I can hold them.
I know. They lie. They lie. Tequila, tequila, tequila. That's all you do. You. 532. 532. I can't stand Islam, dear. I have all the knowledge. 434. No. I'm quoting the Quran to you. I'm quoting. I'm quoting the Quran. I don't learn your bloody book. I don't give a shit about your book. I care about the bits where you...
It's Surah 532, which is what is quoted a lot, many times, after an atrocity is committed. So this is what I'm trying to get them to do, because they always leave out the middle part of 532. They say the first part, and then they say the last part, but they leave out the middle part of the sentence, which is quite crucial. And so for some reason, he's avoiding it.
Are you sure you're a woman? I don't think you're a woman. I don't think you're a woman. Give me 532.
I gave you this. You haven't.
Thanks, Terry.
Read it.
I gave you the
No, you haven't. You didn't. Say it to me.
Listen to me.
Go ahead. Tell me.
I told you. 532. I'm 29.
Well, go ahead. Read it. Go on and read it.
I told you already.
Go ahead. I want 532.
Why don't you bring it up?
You won't read it.
I did.
What about 434? 532. Come on and read it.
Do you want me to read it again?
Yeah, go on in. Let's do it. Let's do this.
Okay.
529. Go on in. No, you read. You read it.
No, because you read it.
It's in Arabic, you idiot. I'm not a scholar.
That's right, Cheryl.
You seem like that you're a scholar.
I have knowledge. You don't need to be. You don't need to. That's such a load of rubbish. That's a red herring. Give me 532. You won't do it. You see, this is what, guys. He will not do it because he knows that 532 is all about killing people.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. Oh, language.
No, you just called me.
No, I didn't use the F word. That's very naughty. I called you stupid. Big difference between stupid and the F word.
529, yeah. It says, go and make a peace treaty.
Yeah.
They have 4 conditions.
Right.
If these people break your conditions,
yeah.
They come and break the conditions. They try to rape or kill your people within the treaty. Give them 40 days to move. If they don't move, go and kill them.
Right. That's not very peaceful. That's not very nice. But that's not 532.
I'm giving you the context.
Not in your context. You've reinterpreted it. That's not how the Quran... That's not what it says in the Quran.
You didn't ask me.
That's not... I've got 4 Qurans and it doesn't say
exactly,
that.
Terry.
4 copies. 4 different versions. And they all say the same thing.
You only need one.
Well, I'm just checking. Because of translation. Somebody might have got the translation a bit mixed up. 532, but he won't give it to me. He won't. He keeps going 529. Give me 532. No, 532. It's about killing one man. If you kill one man...
Absolutely not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
That's the one you did. It's as if you kill all mankind.
No, it's not.
Right? You kill the whole of humanity.
Right? If you kill one man, right? That's what you say. If it's, you know, it's a religion of peace. If you kill one, it's as if you kill all mankind. But you skip out the middle part of that verse.
I gave you the context.
No, you...
I gave you the context.
What's unless the for part? Mischief or murder. So right, on the land. Anything. It can be interpreted as anything. You could just be annoyed with me stepping on your land and you could kill me. Okay? No, it's true. It's true. That's 532. That's 532. No, that's yours. The Muslims don't seem to know how to interpret it. They're very confused about peace.
What about
I think you're confusing peace with war.
What about 2119?
Don't know that one. 434 I don't like very much.
Fight those who fight you. What about that one?
Well, you guys choose to fight first, and then we fight back.
No, fight those who fight you.
And you fight first. So we fight you.
How does that make sense?
It happens. You guys go. That's what Muhammad told you to do.
Fight those who fight you.
Muhammad told you, right? Told the Muslims to spread Islam. Islam is the one and only true religion. It's the only relevant one, correct?
True, that's right.
Nothing else can stay. So you have to kill everybody. You either convert, you pay a jizya, or you die. That is exactly right. I've heard you say it.
How did you survive?
Listen, hold on.
Well, because this is England, and this is a democracy.
Because you're killing everybody, killing you.
Well, you are killing. You guys are killing everybody. Well, you better not kill me, because I'm in England. I'm in England, you idiot. You're not allowed to do that here. You get arrested.
Can you tell me a Muslim that killed an MP?
What?
Can you tell me any Muslim that killed an MP?
What's that got to do with the price of bread?
The right wing have killed an MP.
No, rubbish. That's a lie. No. What about London Bridge? How about Westminster? How about Manchester? How about 9/11? Well, Saddam Hussein, he killed the Kurds and he invaded Kuwait. It was a legitimate war. A legitimate war. He was aggressive.
What about Iraq?
Wait, one at a time.
What about Afghanistan?
He's dead,
Afghanistan?
By the way.
He's a white guy.
What?
From Eugene.
Well, because he's white, he's my father.
Tony Blair.
That's very racist.
Hold on.
What?
Where's the WMDs? Where's the
you
WMDs?
You guys are killing everybody.
Where's the WMDs?
You suck at peace. Let me just tell you guys, you suck at peace.
Where's the WMDs?
You don't understand what peace means. It doesn't mean war, by the way. Hey, I don't care. There's too many right now.
Exactly.
You guys are taking over. And I'm trying to fight back here, guys.
She doesn't care.
I don't want you here. I don't want Islam in England.
I
want Christianity. I want you guys to just go quietly.
We don't want you here.
I don't
want
to kill you.
This is London.
I don't want to kill you. This is my country, not yours.
We don't want you here.
Yeah, this is England. What?
We don't want you here because you are not a Londoner.
Who are you?
We are Londoners.
What are you?
Yes.
How do you know where I live?
We are London.
How do you know where I live? You don't know where I live.
Where?
I'm from London, you idiot.
You are here.
So I belong
here. You are a hate
I live in London.
You are a hate preacher.
No. I'm preaching facts.
You're preaching hate.
Facts.
You're preaching hate.
Facts. Truth.
The reality is Islam is not going anywhere.
Truth? Oh, it is.
It's not going anywhere.
Donald Trump is going to get rid of you guys. President Trump is
going to
get... He's smashed ISIS, you idiots. You guys, the caliphate. By the way, guys, remember, newsflash, the caliphate is gone. The caliphate has gone. It's no more. Caliphate kaput. President Trump destroyed ISIS. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. President Trump's the man. He got rid of you guys. Who? I don't like Saudi Arabia.
Are you Aussie? Are you Aussie?
I'm British.
But are you Aussie?
I'm British!
But you've done it.
What are you? You don't sound... No, you don't sound it. You don't sound it.
It's kaput.
Which one? The great... It's just my grandfather, actually. My grandfather fought in the Second World War. Oh, rubbish.
What? Do you want to see?
Wait, I'm talking about today, dear. I'm talking about today. Today. Well, you told me F, you know, so, you know, let's go with the words. Well, you're deceitful.
Because, no, how could I be?
You practice taqiyya. You lie. You lie about the Quran. You lie about the truth. I know what you're doing. Look, I know the truth. Go practice your lies on somebody who gives them monkeys. I don't care. No, I don't respect Islam. Islam wants to take over. You have no right to take over. I do not give Islam permission to take over this country.
Who are you?
I am a British citizen.
I'm a British citizen too.
Well, but you don't. You're Muslim. You're Muslim first.
No, I'm a British.
You're Muslim first.
What does Islam teach me?
You're Muslim first.
Shall I tell you one thing?
Oh, don't tell me yet. You have to obey the laws of the land you live in. Well, you know what? You've got to remind you guys because you seem to have forgotten that.
No, I do.
You're trying to make the laws.
I'm not.
Oh yeah.
I'm not.
You person,
should I tell you myself?
I don't care.
No, you got to.
You're just a liar. You
know, I'm a liar.
I don't care about you,
no,
personally.
Please.
You personally, I really couldn't care less about.
You know that.
Sorry?
How pathetic and how sad you are.
No, I'm not.
Because you're calling me this, calling me that.
No, you're calling me. About,
no, I have to because...
I don't care about you personally, dear.
No, that's what you're telling me.
I really don't care about you personally.
You
personally,
me?
I couldn't care less.
So why are you
I couldn't care less. It's the ideology that I cannot despise. I despise your ideology.
What's the ideology?
It's death. War, rape, pillaging, destruction. That is Islam. That is Islam. Everywhere. Throughout, it's riddled with it. Every death, destruction, rape. No, I am. I am for my protection.
Okay, that's fine. Because I'm not...
Where's the peace? Where's the peace in Islam? Where's the peace? No. Islam. Tell me where.
I tell you one.
Where?
You're a simple irritated at the moment.
I am. I'm very annoyed with Islam right now. Okay, I'm really irritated.
Okay, if I come to
because
your house,
my free speech is being threatened in this country and it's cut in this park.
How?
Because of
us?
Hate speech, how? Blasphemy laws. How? Your Sharia is trying to take over. Sorry? You'll have to find me, dear.
No,
I don't care about you personally.
No,
you personally seem like a nice guy.
But why you're hurting
you personally seem like a nice man.
I'm a Muslim.
Yeah, but you're not all of Islam, though, are you?
Yeah.
You're not all of Islam.
I follow my law, my Islam.
This was Speaker's Corner on the 18th of March when Tommy Robinson gave his... He'd already given his speech and he'd gone. So I went back in to have more chats. More chit-chats, you know, with the locals.
But it's Britain you're living in.
Of course.
I'll give you an example. I come here...
And the man I'm speaking to that I didn't realise at the time is the one who swiped the policeman with the stick. I hadn't realised it was he who had committed the offence and was walking free merely 2 hours later in a different jacket. So I didn't know it was him until somebody pointed it out to me after the fact.
Understand about democracy?
Of course I do.
Well, if you practice Islam, then it doesn't believe in democracy.
Should I say you? My Prophet Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said...
Sorry?
Our Prophet, Muhammad bin
Qasim. No.
He said...
Well, the fake prophet.
No, he's not.
He was. But self-proclaimed. He proclaimed himself as a prophet. I'm telling you, he self-proclaimed as a prophet.
That's your opinion.
That doesn't make him a prophet.
No, I'm saying to you...
I can say I'm the queen, it doesn't make me the queen.
That's your opinion.
That's true. He was in a cave, right? He was in a cave.
Okay, should I answer that
right?
question?
He came out and he said, "Oh, the angel Gabriel told me God wants to talk to me." That's what he said. Isn't that what he said? Is that what he said?
You made a point. Can I answer that?
I'm telling you.
Can I answer that?
I'm asking you.
That's what I'm saying to you. No, it's not.
Did he not do that?
He didn't do that.
He didn't come from a cave.
No, he
didn't say he heard from Gabriel.
Do you know the context of
it? Did he? I don't care. You know, it's fact. Did he?
No,
what did he do?
Okay, let me explain.
Tell me.
Careful language, Terry. I don't like that word.
He's 40 years old.
No,
I go to 40. Skip to 40. No, I don't care about when he's born.
Listen,
no, because he wasn't a holy birth. There wasn't a holy birth.
Number of comments.
40 years old is when he became. I don't have time. I'm cold. So just let's skip. Let's do a short. No, I'm not lying. I'm telling the truth. You can't handle the truth. You can't handle the truth. Muslims can't handle the truth. Because it's all about hate and death, destruction, takeover, submission. Submission. That's what you believe in. Takeover. Intolerance. Intolerance. You are intolerant. Yeah, I know. I'm ranting. Oh, you're calm.
Calm, and how hateful you are.
No, it's not hate.
You are.
It's not hate.
I'm going to explain to you. You made loud.
I said I don't hate you.
You're not allowed to explain.
What? Well, because you keep on going back to the year dog, which is kind of boring.
No,
I haven't got time to do that. It's cold,
understand.
It's getting colder.
You need to put the context.
Context. All I can see is that you lot want to kill anybody who's not Muslim. Yeah.
You lot.
Islam. Yeah, you lot.
You know what? I'm really sorry.
You can't cope.
No, I think.
Can you not cope with reality?
No, it's not the reality.
Is that hurting your feelings?
Is
it hurting your feelings?
It's not at all.
Oh.
You have the right.
Well, then
to
what's
say
wrong with saying? What does you lot mean?
You lot is a racist lie.
What?
It's a racist lie.
Oh my God! Wait a minute. You lot.
Yeah.
Me is a racist.
Yeah,
how?
Because you are.
Do you understand what it means?
It does.
What does it mean?
Because you don't know me.
So what does you lot mean?
You are including. You are emphasizing that I'm a terrorist. I'm here to kill.
I never called you that.
That's what
I never said
you.
That. Those
what
words.
Do you mean?
Wait a minute.
That's what you said.
That's what happened. You guys twist things so badly. All I said was you lot, and you interpreted me as saying that you're a terrorist. You want to kill everybody. When I said you lot.
You lot. That's what he
that
said.
To you interpreted you lot as you're a terrorist and you want to kill everybody.
Thanks, Helene.
Oh, you know what? That's a load of bullshit. Bloody, this should not be allowed.
Oh, here we go. This is what
I'm going to go to the police and I'm going to find out. I'm going to say, listen.
This?
Look, I'm sorry, but that's causing me harassment, alarm and distress, what they're doing. So I'd like you to ask them to stop doing that. Why not? That's not allowed. It's not. How is it allowed? It's a gathering. They're not. Have they got a permit to do that?
What, for praying?
For doing that?
I don't think you need a permit for praying.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm quite convinced on that.
I'm feeling very alarmed at what they're doing.
Well,
their activities.
Okay. Well, solve that situation. If you move away from it, you won't be able to see it.
Well, they're there. They shouldn't be allowed to do that.
That's an alarm to distress.
Oh, so you interpret that, right? Somebody else is harassed along the track, and you interpret it how it suits you.
How would you like me to interpret it?
As I'm saying it.
Okay, well, I'm not going to deal with that.
Why not?
Because they're praying, and I think that's perfectly fine.
Really?
Yes.
So you think that's okay?
Yes, I do.
You don't think that's sort
no,
of
I
causing
that's okay.
harassment, alarm, and distress?
I don't think they're causing any issue by praying.
Yeah, you're dimmied. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
You're dimmied. What?
I'm what?
Dimmied.
Dimmied?
Yes, you're
I don't understand that word, so...
Well, so basically...
Thank you, I'm from the West Country, so please do explain.
It means you're being submissive to the Muslims. That's what, okay. That's what they believe.
Well, it's not.
When
that
they
is.
Call you, when
okay,
they call
that's,
you that.
Well, that's nice.
True.
Okay. Well, I don't agree with you.
No, I know you don't, and but so it's therefore. True.
Okay. I've enjoyed talking to you. Yeah, I've learned a little bit.
No, come on. You haven't really enjoyed talking to me.
I have.
No, you haven't.
Do you know what? I've not realised how cold it is while I've been talking to you. So, I've actually have enjoyed talking to you.
Have you?
Yeah.
Ah, I've enjoyed talking to you too.
Good, I'm not surprised. Your eyes aren't painted on, are they?
What?
You treat yourself there. See, your eyes aren't painted on. That's a West Country saying. It means you're having a good look and you're enjoying yourself.
I haven't heard that expression. Yeah. I'll have to look it up.
Yeah.
Right, I'll see you later. No, it's too cold.
Okay, see you later.
But I'm very unhappy with them doing that here. That's representing hatred.
I don't pray.
Oh, so you're ordering him. He can't talk to me? Why can't he talk to me?
Just by them praying.
Well, that's in your opinion. That's horrible. I think it's terrible. I think that's a disgrace. It's a disgrace.
This is the country who gave me the
we're Britain. Christian.
Prince wasn't always Christian. Christian was Middle East religion.
Yeah, I can't stand that. Hey, Phil.
Just go away from me.
Get out of my space. Go away from me. You're standing too close. You're invading my space.
Really?
Yeah.
Why are you here?
Same as everyone else is here.
Yeah, we're here.
What do you mean, why am I here? I'm here to talk.
Freedom country. You
don't believe in that.
You can't do what you want.
You don't believe in that.
What?
Freedom.
Yeah.
Islam doesn't.
They're free to the free. Yeah.
Islam believes in submission.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, no, because you can't. Yeah. You said when I. Oh, wait. You said, so you lot, when I said you lot, so you'll go back to that. No.
That's what she.
No, I didn't. No.
I
said you lot, referring to Muslims.
You can.
Referring to
Muslims,
you lot.
It's your right.
But you interpreted.
No, you can say whatever you
want.
Good,
thanks, Phil. Talk over me. You're going to keep talking over me.
Has a law.
You're going to have me speak. No, you don't.
This country welcomes immigration. They
I've seen.
We came here wow. To be Christian.
No. Really?
We're
going to make a change.
What?
Yeah.
If you have the power, why not?
It's going to change. It is going
to
change.
Some might say that's just as absurd as trying to enforce Sharia here.
But Sharia is being enforced. Hate speech, it's blasphemy. Yeah, it is.
It's arbitration.
No, it's not. It's hate speech. It's blasphemy law. Sharia law is being practiced in this country by British police. People are being arrested. People being prevented to come into this country.
You did a scoping?
They wanted to do a speech. And you know why? They were asked what their political beliefs and what their religious beliefs were. That is Sharia. Okay?
That
prevented them. Yeah.
That's one way.
Teach us about Sharia. Let's teach us. What is Sharia law?
350, what's that?
Why would they stop from coming here?
What is Sharia law?
Could you just get away from me? I don't like you being so close to me, quite frankly. Just don't step in my space.
That's your space?
Yeah, my space is my space. Right about here, right? That's my space right there. That's my space. Just don't get close to me.
Tell me about Sharia law. What do you know about Sharia law?
It's terrible.
Tell me what?
It's undemocratic.
Really?
Totally against democracy.
Sharia law in UK?
Yes. It exists.
Maybe ask the officer, is there Sharia law in
the Well, he's going to say no. That's because they're under your control.
I'm happy.
I know you're happy. You're happy. You're winning. You are winning right now. You're winning.
Of course.
But we're going to defeat you.
Islam is most growing religion at the moment.
But it's going to be defeated. Don't worry.
How?
By President Trump.
No way.
President Trump.
No way.
ISIS is dead.
Civilization.
Sorry?
Without Muslim innovation.
Muslim innovation? No, don't take credit for anything. You guys just break and kill and destroy. You don't build anything. You just destroy. It wasn't Muslim.
What is your education?
I know.
Can I ask?
Yeah, degree. I've got degrees. None of your business. None of your business. I have knowledge. I've got the Quran. I have... Sorry?
She called me.
Don't listen, you can't BS me. Okay, I know the reality. I know what's going on, and I'm not putting up with it, okay? I'm speaking out against Islam. It's a hateful ideology. There's nothing peaceful about it. It's submit, kill, or die. That's what the...
Oh, my God, Aline.
It's disgusting. And as a woman, I particularly despise it. Because you don't respect women in Islam, okay? Women have no rights.
You're just talking.
I'm just saying.
Okay. So you want to look at some people's understanding.
I see it happening. I don't need anybody to tell me. I can see, I have eyes, I have ears, and I have a mind. And I can see the reality.
And the reality is, it's not friendly. Not tolerant.
Oh, my gosh.
You want to take over.
Okay, so when
you want to take over.
So when you go to study university.
I've done it.
No, I'm talking. When we go to university or school or college, we go to the teacher, isn't it? To learn. Who is learning?
Look, just stop it, okay? You guys seem, for some reason, you don't seem to be able to think that you can think, have an opinion.
Intellectual people's work.
No, he didn't.
I don't care about these people.
But you don't. Because
you're
little mind.
You wouldn't even read out the Surah 532 or 434. I'm not interested in that. Not interested in that. I have the Quran. I have the Quran. I know about Muhammad. I know all I need to know. I've seen the practices. I've seen what's going on in Europe. I've seen what's going on in the Middle East. I've seen what's going on in Africa. I've seen what's going on in here. And it's all... Tony Blair's an idiot.
Well, I will now, Phil.
It was a legitimate war. It was a legitimate war, yeah. Because Saddam Hussein killed the Kurds.
Oh, thanks, Connie.
Yeah, it's true.
Oh, you're surprised how well they speak, sorry. I thought you said how well I speak.
Listen, 9-11 was you lot as well. 9-11 was Islam. 9-11. Vegas, London Bridge, Westminster Bridge, Manchester bombing, all Islam. That makes, you know what, I can sleep better now, knowing that you condemn it. Oh, wow. Thank you so
Thanks,
much.
Ms. Kerja.
Terrific. It's everything. It's the life. It's the laws. Okay. Women. Yeah.
All right. So he's gonna start talking to me, and then I'm gonna start doing it. And then they bring Paul, their favorite, the who they think is their secret weapon, and I end up having fun with Paul. Here he is. Do you want to see me with Paul? No, I haven't got security. Connie, do you want to see, this is, I didn't know this person before he showed up, but they're his secret weapon, apparently. Do you want to hear him talking to me? Let's think. Oh, Terry. I know.
Free speech with violent speech.
No, they weren't speaking violence. Wait a minute. They were not going to speak violence.
Okay, so
they were going to talk about free speech, for goodness sake. And it had nothing to do with violence. However, they got stopped from entering this country. That is ridiculous.
I don't agree that this is happened.
That's why we're here.
I don't agree that she's
That's why we're here, okay. To speak out against that control. Yes. That's the problem. Lauren Southern. Blonde Canadian girl. She couldn't come to England. She was stopped in Calais.
Right.
She was stopped in Calais.
Yes.
And she was prevented. Wait. She was prevented from coming here. All she wanted to do was talk to somebody.
Right.
And she was not allowed. She was banned. That is Sharia. Tell me. I'm telling you now. That is a blasphemy. That's Sharia. That is Sharia control. That is not a British democracy. Okay? So we're in trouble. So that's why we're here today. Do you not agree that that's crazy?
If it was like that, what I'm saying is the reason. The civic reason.
No, they wouldn't let you, Phil.
The civic reason why they stopped her wasn't because she was coming here to give a speech.
Why was it?
Because of previous actions that she had been taking part in.
Yeah, what was it?
And
what was she doing? Do you know?
I think they referred to her involvement with the ship in the Mediterranean.
She was in Luton. She was in Luton, handing out pamphlets.
Handing out pamphlets.
Leaflets. Yeah.
And what did those pamphlets say?
Nothing about Sharia.
I know. Really?
Well, even if it was about Sharia. Is that a way to, no violence, no nothing. We don't talk violence. Okay.
Is a violent statement I'm about to say? All Muslims should be forced to move from the country. Is that a violent statement?
Well, it depends what kind of force. What kind of force? Yeah. You mean if they're arrested and then put on a boat or put on a plane and flown away? That's not violent.
You don't think people being arrested purely because of their faith, that's violent?
What?
You don't think it's violent, purely because of their choice of faith.
That's not, no, do you know what violence means? Violence is pain.
Right.
Pain, hurt, ouchie.
Okay, so you're...
Ow!
So, okay, so...
That's hurt, that's pain.
Right.
Hate speech, saying I don't like Islam, I don't like Muhammad. That's all of that qualifies.
Speech,
no, no, no.
Okay with that.
No, no, but we're not allowed to do that. No, no. Muslims are not allowed to criticize Muhammad. That's hate speech. It's crazy. Right. We're in a cray-cray world right now, and it's happening because people are being prevented from entering this country because of words they want to say. They want to speak about the situation with free speech and what Islam is doing, which is what it's doing. It's working and it's succeeding.
I'm an Englishman.
Right?
I live up the road.
Terrific.
And do you think there's free speech down here?
Now, here he comes. Here comes this guy who I did not know from Adam, never seen him before, and he just wanders along and says, hello, I'm English. I'm an Englishman and I'm from up the road. Yes, hello, my name's Paul. And then he goes from there.
Okay. Have you been here before?
Yeah.
There's free speech going on right now.
No, there is. But it's very... But people have been prevented... Wait a minute, sorry. People have been prevented from coming here to speak.
That's right.
So it's a different... You know, you can have free speech here. But I don't know that I'm not going to be arrested.
Because I'm saying, I've been coming here for years, and there's free speech. People criticise Muslims and Muhammad and the Quran.
Is that fair, Chris? Is that fair, though?
In very, very strong language.
Like what? Like what?
Does it, Lizzie does it.
Like what? Smith, what do they say?
They say Muhammad's a paedophile.
Is
say,
he? Was he? In our term?
No.
Wait, no. You just said that they call him a paedophile as if that's an example. Wait, no. You just wait. You just gave that
What's
as
name,
a... Amy. You just gave
my
that as
Paul,
a...
Amy.
Hello, Paul. Wait.
What I'm saying.
You just said... You gave that as an example. You said...
Yes.
They, by them saying
yes.
He was a paedophile, which is factually correct. In our in our laws, how the British laws go, that is correct. That is factually correct because he did marry a child of 6. And he had sexual intercourse with her at the age of 9. That would be... Wait. Under our laws, would be considered a paedophiliac act.
It would be, you're right.
Yes. So therefore, you should be able to say that. So, but you said.
But people are allowed to say it. My point to you is, if I make
said they said things hate. You know that they shouldn't say.
I never said hate. I never said.
What did you say?
I'm talking about free speech here.
Right.
I never mentioned the word hate yet.
Okay.
My point is this: that free speech at Speaker's Corner, where people are free to criticise Islam in the way that Muslims will find very offensive.
Okay, Sherry. Thanks.
Watch out.
Finish.
Let me finish.
Offensive to Muslims. What's that mean?
Well, let me finish. Free speech has been allowed where people can criticize Muhammad in the ways that Muslims find extremely offensive. And I can tell you that Muslims have not reacted in a violent way at all to the speech.
That's not true.
The Hatun, well, you know differently.
I've seen it. On you, just look at YouTube. See how much violence there is on there. And guess what? We never had violence. Yes, here. Yes. Yes.
Well, Hatton has been, and Lizzie and others, Jay Smith has boasted that he's been here for decades. He's now back in America now. He's never been attacked in
well,
Speaker's
that's
Corner.
That's good for him.
Good for him.
That doesn't mean it doesn't happen.
He has been attacked. There was a time
so there you go.
With different Qurans. And he was trying to give a speech. Yes, he was. They filmed it.
So do you believe in...
I'm not aware that if he's attacked, then fair enough, I'm wrong. But it's extremely rare. No, let me finish.
Well.
Okay, but it shouldn't happen ever.
It's extremely rare. What I'm saying is that Muslims put up with...
Why are they separate? Why is there separate? Why is there a separate between religions? You're specifying Muslims.
I'm finishing my point. Because we're talking about Islam and Muslims.
Right.
Yeah? We're not talking about Hindus or anyone
right.
else. So there is free speech. Muslims, usually, 99% of the time, maybe there's some exceptions, maybe you're right, usually put up with the most, in their eyes, the most offensive...
Their eyes.
Yes.
We don't go. We don't measure by their eyes.
No.
We're living in a democracy.
Right.
Every religion is fair game. Every religion should be fair game. It's not! Why are we separating Islam then? If it's all equal... Wait, no. Answer my question. Why are we separating Muslims?
I don't understand your question. What are we separating Muslims? What does that mean?
don't play games.
No, I'm not. I don't know. It's separating yeah. what Islam means. Can you
you're
play
separating.
More
well, you separate. You're saying Muslims specifically yeah. get offended by what people say.
No, some Muslims.
Are they allowed to criticize?
When there is great criticism. But Christians also.
No, no, don't
get,
no,
Christians
yeah.
also get offended down here, presumably. I know, because as a Muslim, I'm a Muslim.
All right. How did I not know? I could have known. I could have said that.
I can tell you.
No, I know, but I can tell.
Unless you're psychic.
By the fact that you're defending Islam.
I'm a white guy. I'm a Muslim. I believe there's one God. Muhammad
well, I'm
God,
sure probably because you like having second kids or something.
That's low.
Why would somebody who's British choose to take up Islam?
Trigger.
Okay, guys, I take it back. I'm sorry. That was a very rude thing to say. I apologize.
Okay,
I apologize. That was very out of order. Let's keep it civilized.
I'm an Englishman, you're an Englishman. Let's behave like decent people.
Let's do that.
Right. So coming back to the point, Muslims down here. They behave themselves very well. Exceptions. And there's a Muslim here who was arrested today. I noticed for assaulting a policeman.
That was the start of the violence.
He was arrested because he was behaving badly. However, two Christians down here the year before last arrested for attacking a Jew.
Wait a minute.
Assaulted a Jew.
Okay.
Two Christians.
Paul.
We all behave badly at times.
Let me ask you a question.
Christians assault
Paul.
Jews. They get
rubbish.
Arrested. They go to
rubbish.
Court.
Rubbish.
No, it's on YouTube. It was
rubbish.
Filmed. It's not rubbish.
No other people, listen, I don't, look, come on, guys. Let's be real.
Paul,
you are deceitful. You are deceitful. Islam.
What happened to the manners?
I'm calling you deceitful. Because you're BSing, Paul.
I'm not, this is true.
You have converted to Islam. You've chosen, excuse me.
Physically assaulted.
You're
sorry.
You're just, you're totally, you're a liar. Why did you go to Islam? When did you?
This is a fact.
Hello? Hello, I'm talking to you. Hello? Why did you convert? When did you convert?
Can I ask you one question?
I asked you.
Yeah.
Answer me.
Can I ask you?
I asked you. No. Right. I'm asking you.
I'm going to ask you anyway.
No, I'm asking you.
Will
see
you,
your own answer.
Will you
That's what Muslims do.
And be civil with me.
I'm being civil.
No, you just called me deceitful.
So?
For no reason.
Oh, is it words again? It's words. Oh, my gosh. Hateful words.
You
can't cope.
Are you going to have any consistency? I'm sorry. Are you going to have any consistency?
He's being deceitful.
You're being inconsistent.
How am I being
fed up? You're trailing off. You're not
people's...
being very intellectual, yeah. Adam.
How
sorry,
am I
being deceitful?
It really bothers me.
Brother.
Brother?
Yes, he's my youngest brother.
Brother.
He is a brother.
What a brother.
He is a Benny Adam. He is a son of Adam. I am a son of Adam.
When did you convert?
And you are my sister.
Wait, no, I'm not. Well,
that's personal.
No, you're not, no,
you're
not my brother.
Can you have a
you're not my brother. No, you're not my family. Yeah, I have my own family.
You're my sister.
I have my, no, I'm not.
He is my brother, you imagine.
I do not accept that.
And he, is
Paul.
My
when did you convert? When did you convert?
My brother in faith.
Hello.
Well, that's a
you can't answer that question.
About 10 years ago.
10 years ago.
And what made you convert?
Because I believed Islam was true. Muhammad was the prophet of God.
But why?
I also used to be a Christian. I used to be a born again Christian.
What would make you go?
Jesus
so you think it's okay
God?
To dominate?
Will you let me finish?
I'm saying to you.
No,
do you think it's okay for Islam to dominate the world?
No,
to take over?
No, that's not what we want.
What does Islam mean?
Islam means submission to the one God.
And who needs to do that?
Jesus said...
No, I don't want Jesus. I'm not talking Jesus. I'm not interested in Jesus.
Let me answer my own way.
Who needs to submit? Who needs to submit to him?
We all need
who?
To submit to the
Muslims.
God.
No.
All humanity.
No,
he doesn't
no,
want to
they
go.
Don't.
Okay.
No, it's a free choice.
Are you a Christian?
Free choice.
The Quran says it's a free
choice.
Free,
I'm not, I don't care about the... No, the Quran doesn't give you free choice.
It is. There's no compulsion in religion. It
yeah, but then it says a lot of other things after that, saying to kill the non-believers.
No,
the kufar.
No,
the kufar. Oh, God, there we go. No.
Have you read the Quran? Obviously
yes, I have.
For all of this?
No, well...
No, you haven't, clearly.
Is that a requirement? Do I have to read the whole thing? It's not in order. It's not in order. It's not in chronological order, so what does it matter?
It makes sense, though.
No, it doesn't. That's the problem. It makes no sense.
How do you know it doesn't make sense?
It doesn't make any sense.
You said you haven't read it all. I have it. Maybe you were to read it all, you'd understand it.
Paul, you are a sad Englishman who's deserted Christianity. You believe... Well, it's true.
You should have more manners.
It's true. I don't care.
Englishman...
I can speak a free speech. I can say what I like, Paul. And if you can't cope with my words... then that's your problem.
I'm calling you to good behaviour.
And I think, as an Englishman, shame on you. Shame on you. Shame on you, Paul. Shame on you. Shame on you. Shame on you, the warrior. You can't look at me. He's looking at these other people. He can't look at me. Because you are shameful. You're a disgrace to the British people. You believe in a hateful war ideology that spreads hatred, death and destruction. So tell me, Paul.
You're talking every act. No. You don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, no, ignorant, no.
You are not speaking.
That's your problem. Your problem is, no.
And it is a peaceful book which talks about...
Peaceful?
Yes.
Oh, my God, there's nothing peaceful in it. There's nothing peaceful in it. I haven't read the whole book. There's plenty of hatred in it.
You don't read it all.
I don't have to read it all.
You do.
Surah 5... Listen, stop. Everybody stop with you. Surah 532, right? That all the Muslims... quote, whenever there's, another terrorist attack committed by, a Muslim.
So?
Where's the peace?
Where's the
peace? Where are they? Where are they? Where are they? Where? I've never seen one.
Well, I have.
I've never seen any. You've not seen any Ku Klux Klan. There's no Ku Klux Klan, dear. Don't exist. They do not. They're a little group of people. When's the last time? What did they do? And what did they?
They believe in the Bible.
They believe in the Bible.
And they burn and kill black
people.
Who?
When? When?
Oh my God!
When?
When's
the last time? When's the last time the Ku Klux Klan committed that crime?
I don't know. You Google it.
No, you're accusing them. So when did they do it? When did they do it? I could give you a whole shed load of examples.
She wants to question that. I can. Ku Klux Klan was like 100 years ago. She's not worried about that. Is that correct?
I'm not worried about Ku Klux Klan today.
Yes, exactly.
Today, I'm worried about my safety. And you know the only people I'm worried about are Muslims. Okay? The Ku Klux Klan, Muslims.
Mostly Muslims and a few non-Muslims. And I guarantee your safety.
And so I bloody well should be safe in England. At Speaker's Corner. Are you telling me I shouldn't feel safe?
No. It's wrong.
Is that what you're saying to me?
You're wrong. You're prejudiced. You have ideas.
I have
you
facts.
You need to educate yourself.
No, I'm educated.
You need to live up to the high calling of being
you're getting excited.
And learn.
Calm down.
Use your brain.
I know enough.
Don't think from your...
So what happened at London Bridge? Westminster Bridge.
Terrorism.
Manchester.
Terrorism.
By what?
Nothing to do with Islam.
By whom?
Nothing to do with
there
Islam.
There you go. That's your cop out. Everything to do with Islam. And that's your problem. You shameful man. You are a disgrace and a traitor to your country and your people. You are a disgrace. It had everything to do with Islam. Everything. A Muslim did it.
I want you to give me 30 seconds of uninterrupted airtime.
Right.
I want to explain something to you. Brothers, I want to explain. Brothers, humanity, etc. The Quran, Islam condemns terrorism. Why do I say this? Because there are many authentic statements of the Prophet Muhammad, which are rigorously authenticated, where he says, do not kill women, do not kill children, do not kill monks, do not kill priests, do not kill non-combatants. Mm. It is haram to touch them. Yeah. Even trees, even livestock are not to be touched in warfare. Wow. Yeah. So when a so-called Muslim in Muslim's name goes out in the name of Islam and commits acts of terrorism, he is violating the very teachings of his faith.
Why does he do
it? Supposed to uphold.
Why does he refer to it?
I would say that Islam does not support terrorism. It refutes it, rejects it, and condemns it.
And Paul.
And lastly, I would say
you are a liar.
In Sharia,
and a shameful liar.
Hang on, brother.
You are lying.
I'm finished.
You are lying through your teeth. You are practicing taqiyya. You shameful man. Shame on you. Shame on you for lying. Every single terrorist attack is committed by a Muslim. Okay? Everyone. Let's go statistically. Statistically speaking. And why does he say Aloha Snack Bar every time he's going to bloody do something? Aloha Snack Bar. That's what he says.
Aloha what?
Aloha Snack Bar.
Aloha.
Yeah, yeah. That's what he says. I'm not going to say those words, you stupid idiot.
That's not what he says. You can't even.
I don't care. I'm not going to say it. I refuse to utter those disgusting words. Aloha Snack Bar. Aloha Snack Bar is not what they say. I know what they say, and I'm intentionally saying it incorrectly. But that's what they say before they commit acts of violence. Running people over, stabbing people, cutting people's throats, smite them at their necks, to the letter. Right. To the letter, they're following it.
Hang on,
they're following it to the letter, jihad.
20 seconds
to dominate. No, I've already gave it to you. I gave it to you. God, he wants another time.
Let me explain again.
But you're just lying again.
I want the people who are viewing this.
You're shameful. You're a disgrace. You're a disgrace. You're a disgrace. What happens to homosexuals?
I'm finished.
Well, I don't care. What happens to homosexuals?
I look at Mohammed on.
Hello, Paul. Hello. Paul. Hello. What happens to homosexuals? Well, you were supposed to be talking to me, actually. I was giving. Well, that's because it doesn't suit you. Because you cannot answer. What happens to homosexuals? What happens in Islam?
Nothing.
Get chucked from buildings.
No,
oh, God. Oh, my God. You know, what's the point of me having it? Look, I
reported.
Are you denying that? So you haven't seen them? You haven't seen it?
You speak from the
You haven't seen it? No, it's knowledge. Visual. It's visual.
Show me. Where does it say in the Quran to do that?
Where in the Quran? All right, guys, listen. This is really ridiculous because these guys are practicing. This is a shameful Englishman. If you see him, just tell him he's shameful. He's a bloody traitor. The cake. Look, he can't look at me. He can't look at me. When was the last time? I know why you've gone to. I know why you've gone to Islam. I know exactly why. I can tell. And in fact, if you went there, you would probably be chucked off a building. Yeah, you would. Sorry, mate. So you're in bed with the enemy. You're in bed with the enemy.
Where does it say in the Quran?
Well, tell them to stop chucking people off buildings.
It's not in the Quran.
Well, why are they doing it then?
They are extremists who are not.
No, there's no such thing. It's fundamental. It's fundamental. It's fundamental. The Quran. I can't be what. Listen, it's bloody freezing. Sorry? I love him, yeah. He's fantastic.
You don't have education. No knowledge.
I have every. I have all the education. I do. Listen, you know what? Do you know how much your opinion matters to me? That much. I don't care about your ignorant opinion. Okay? Goodbye. Yeah, Paul, shame on you. You are a disgrace to this country. You are a traitor. You are a traitor. There's a traitor right there to this country. Yeah.
Right. All right, that's it, kids. That was pretty much the end. I was blooming freezing at that point, as you can see. It was trying to snow, and then this blooming woman started to try and talk to me. So I didn't mean to go that far, but that was just some of my experience, kids. I know he is. Of course, I didn't know him before I spoke to him, and obviously since I've met him, I found him on YouTube, and he does this sort of. Oh, hello, yes, I'm an Englishman, just from up the road, you know. Yeah, so, anyway, that was quite fun, actually. I did have fun. I do have a little bit of fun, but I may have a bit of a problem from now on from the ideology of peace. Because, you know, I deigned to speak about the law, which, you know, hey-ho. The ideology of peace doesn't actually particularly care for the man-made laws. Don't you know what I mean? Anywho, kids, I'm going to sign off. I didn't mean to do this long, long video. And I would encourage you, if you want to know, Just Simon 13, actually, he's in my title, is very good at interpreting, explaining the Quran. And he's just great. If you want to know about it without having to read the bloomin' book, which really you don't want to read, trust me, but just watch Just Simon, and he does great documentaries. Some of them are hard to watch because they're quite, well, they're graphic, but it's real. It's the real deal. Thanks. Thanks, Meg. Yeah, you know, it's quite fun. But obviously, I might have. Did you see my video from yesterday, Meg? Hey, Meg, did you see that Paul Joseph Watson retweeted my footage from yesterday? Oh, thanks. #AmyCan. I will check your DM. Thank you, Sherry. I will definitely check. But poor Joseph Watson from Prison Planet. He retweeted my footage from yesterday. Did you hear about that, Meg? That's my mum's... You know what? Wallace, I swear. Wallace is my mother's maiden name. From Scotland. She's from Scotland. Oh, hi, the new lady. So I've got a wee bit of Wallace in me. You know, I do. I'm not kidding. I've got the Scottish, Irish and Italian. And I think, I like to think American because my father was born in America and I was born in America. So I've got some really, really fierce blood running through my veins, baby. Och, I knew. So don't mess with Miss Amy. Or you might meet the wrath of my ham sandwich. I'll wave my ham sandwich at you. Stay back. I've got my ham sandwich. Very fierce. Och, I. Okay, kids, I've got to, you know, what can I say? I'm a wee bit punch drunk on all my tweets. I've got a lot of tweets I've got to go through because, you know, I will be very safe. I'll try not to be arrogant. Yes, arrogance is not very pleasant. It's quite an ugly trait. Oh, yes. Yeah, Meg, it was, well, it'll now be yesterday, it was 20 hours ago, a few hours ago, so it'll be yesterday's tweets. It's in his feed, he retweeted, oh! I mean, it wasn't my direct footage, he retweeted somebody else's tweet. Very exciting. Oh, hi, I've got to have a wee gander, and I had an MBE retweet, and... And Anne van der Steel DM'd me, don't you know? So, very exciting, kids. Very, very exciting. Miss Amy is absolutely... But I will read Animal Farm tomorrow night. It will return tomorrow night, kids. And I will let you know how I get on tomorrow, because, you know, tomorrow's a wee bit D-Day with me and the police. And I'm sure Glendula would be thrilled to bits to know that I've got to see the police tomorrow. Oh, hi. Little Glendula. And the wee Obi. And the wee Glay. And all those sorry, sorry men over there who cannot cope with Miss Amy. Oh, hi. Laddie. Watch out, Miss Amy's coming. Don't you mess with Miss Amy. Or you'll be very, very sorry. Oh, dearie me. Do you know, I haven't done my Scottish accent for a very long time. Oh, no, I haven't done it. Maybe it's the Wallace in me that's just come out when you say Braveheart. Thank you. I need a lot of prayers, people. What was that about my scope views? Oh, thank you very much. Well, you know, I've got a wee bit of Scottish in me. Edinburgh is from where my grandparents were from. Och, aye, laddie, lasses. Mrs. Doubtfire, ach, aye, yes, right. Mrs. Doubtfire, yes, she did have a Scottish accent, didn't she? Oh, to be sure. Anyway, right, that's it. That's enough of my Scottish. I used to do that to my grandparents. I only realised years later how annoying that must have been for them, because every time they spoke, I'd say, och, aye, no, lass, let's go. Och, wee bonnie. You bonnie lass. Let's have a wee bit of haggis. You don't say. Och, aye. Laddie. All right, okay, enough. Enough, Amy. Stop it. I'm sorry. I am, and plus I'm hungry because I'm trying to... I've gone on a bit of a diet, you know, so I'm a wee bit low on my sugar. So I start to go a wee bit silly, you know, when I go into these weird accents. Oh, hi. I kind of see what you're writing. Yeah. Oh, I hate haggis. Haggis is disgusting. Disgusting. You're dieting. Oh, I know. It's terrible. But why? Meg, you don't... Wait a minute, Meg. You don't need to diet. What the hell are you talking about? Ah, yes. I have a wee bacon. a back bacon. I think I'll have crispy bacon with a fried egg, soft on the yolk, over easy. Oh my God, I'm believing myself in a minute. Thanks. Oh, Scottish shortbread. Don't mention the shortbread. Don't. Oh no, my stomach just did a wee bit of a flip. Oh, it's just gurgled on me when you mention the blimmin' shortbread. Damn it. I love shortbread. Oh dear. I just put on a few pounds thinking about the shortbread. All right, I'm going to go now. I'm going to go. Where's my... Should we do my song? Should we do my song? Shall we? Oh, BLT. Oh dear. Bacon, lettuce, tomato. But I can't eat tomato. Should we do my song? Which one should we do? Which one? Okay, stop talking food now, kids. You're making me hungry. No more food talk or you get blocked. I'll be very vicious. I'll block you, the lot of you, if you start talking food. Stop it now. Children, stop it. I'm starving like Marvin. My stomach thinks my throat's been cut. Ooh, that's a terrible expression nowadays. That used to be a funny expression, but now it's not so funny. Not so funny in the climate we live in, don't you know? Okay. I'm trying to find my song, kids. Shall we do we want the Donald? Or do we want the Sarah McLachlan? Do we want the McDonald? Which one do we want? The Trump tequila? Okay, I will stop doing my Scottish. Yeah, let's do POTUS. Okay. Time for POTUS. He did the Easter egg roll today. I've got to find the bloomin'... Oh, of course, I'm on the right page. Okay, I can't see what you're saying. I will have to look at it a wee bit later. Amy can. Hashtag Amy can. I love it. I love it. Right, let me just type this in. And then we shall go, kids. I need to go to bed because I'm a wee bit knackered. I've had quite a long day. All right, stop it, Amy. I'm having a... What? There he is. Wait a minute. No, I don't want that one. Sorry. God, blimey, O'Reilly. Amy destroys hashtag. I like this one. I prefer this one. I like to see him dancing, baby. Thanks for joining me, everybody. I know. I'm in a very silly mood. Cheers, guys. Love you. Hashtag tag, baby. To the moon, baby. To the moon, baby. Bish, bash, bosh. Oh, thanks, Monica. I'll be fine. Thank you for joining, everybody. Thank you. I love you too, Lotta. To the moon, baby. Cheers, Phil. Thanks for coming in, Phil. Thanks, Meg. Mr. Sod. Thanks, Simon. Miss Catcher.
Antifa!
I missed it. Damn. That was very naughty. And look who retweeted me today. He did. Paul Joseph Watson. Woohoo! Oh, yeah. Do that, Meg. Oh, good, Phil. I'm glad you're well. Better. Thank you. Good night, everybody. I love you. Hashtag tag, baby. K-A-G. Oh, that's great. I'm so glad to hear it. Antifa! To the moon, baby. I love you guys. And thank you so much for those of you who have sent some fabulous messages. I so appreciate all your tweets. I've had so many tweets. Oh, no.
You know, they show up in
okay,
the
helmets right.
And the black masks.
Sorry,
and
kids.
They've got clubs and they've got everything. Antifa!
Antifa! Who's that? Celeste? To the moon, baby. Sorry, I accidentally hit the replay. Loved you, Monica. Loved you guys. POTUS is savage, baby. Oh, sorry, Phil. Andrew, who's that? Who's Andrew underscore Davis underscore? I know, I can't stand these people. Not get educated. Antifa! Oh, sorry, Andrew. Sorry. Wait a minute. I don't recognize your... Oh, I'll follow you, Andrew. Welcome. Welcome. Yes, these are Antifa. These are Antifa. Don't you know? These are all the Antifa from the election, don't you know? Antifa? Antifa? Oh, thanks, Meg. Oh, it's amazing. It's been a whirlwind. Yeah, I know, I hate these people. Antifa! No, she can't do anything. She can't win any elections, thank God. Thank God. Thank you, Lord. Evil. Thanks, God. Thanks for getting this wonderful man into power. Love you guys. Hashtag love you. Hashtag hag. Antifa! Right, now I'm really signing off now, guys. I love you. To the moon, baby. Catch up. I'll give you more news tomorrow. Take care. God bless. Have a lovely evening. And thanks very much. Thanks for the support. Oh, Batman's coming. Right, love you. Bye.